We'd like to welcome you to our online service of the Eastern Sierra United Methodist Church. Our hope for this evening, the longest night, a service for wholeness and peace, is to acknowledge and remember both the struggles and the joys that come to our lives during Christmas time, and together to find hope in the coming of Jesus Christ.
Said you'd come and share all my sorrows. You said you'd be there for all my tomorrows. I came so close to sending you away, but just like you promised, you came here to stay. Just had to pray, and Jesus said, come to the waters, stand by my side. I know you are thirsty, you won't be denied. I felt every teardrop when in darkness you I strove to remind you that for those tears I died. Your goodness so great I can't understand, and dear Lord, I know that all this was planned.
Jesus said, come to the water, stand by my side. I know you are thirsty, you won't be denied. I felt every teardrop when in darkness you cried, and I strove to remind you for those tears I died. Jesus, I give you my heart and my soul. I know that without God I'll never be whole. Savior, I thank you and praise you from earth's humble shores. Take me, I'm yours. When Jesus said, come to the waters, stand by my side. I know you are thirsty, you won't be I strove to remind you that for those tears I died.
Welcome to the longest night. The name of this service comes from the season. Tonight is actually the longest night of the year. But the name Longest Night also describes the feeling that a number of us have during this season. In the long, dark winter nights, memories of past experiences and the pain of present experiences and situations can become overwhelming. For some, Christmas Day is the most difficult. For others, Christmas Eve, or New Year's Eve, or the beginning of another lonely year. In this service, we invite you to listen. We invite you to pray. We invite you to sing. We invite you to meditate upon the pain and anguish you may bring. And we invite you to offer your pain to the Christ child. And we trust that you will find hope and comfort in knowing that you are not alone. In the bringing of the light, we hear these scriptures. In this scripture, all are invited to receive God's mercy and grace. Some choose not to come, and those who have felt alienated are invited once again. In God's environment, all are invited. No one is excluded. Psalm 103, verse 8, 13 and 14, and 17 and 18. The Lord is merciful and gracious, slow to anger and abounding in steadfast love. As a father shows compassion to his children, so the Lord shows compassion to the faithful. For the Lord knows our frame and remembers that we are dust. But the steadfast love of the Lord is from everlasting to everlasting upon the faithful, and the righteousness of the Lord to children's children, to those who keep his covenant and remember to do his commandments. And when our burdens get piled up on top of other burdens, the load can crush us. In his promise, Jesus offers us help to carry our burdens and responsibilities. We do not have to bear those alone. He will always help us. We are reminded of this in Matthew 11, verses 28 to 30. Come to me, all you who are struggling hard and carrying heavy loads, and I will give you rest. Put on my yoke and learn from me.
I'm gentle and humble, and you will find rest for yourselves. My yoke is easy to bear, and my burden is light. Amen. Our Lord, with its hurts and hatred, recognizes that this world is not the way God would have us live. God's love promises something so startling new that it takes our breath away. No matter our sorrows, no matter the distance we feel, God is not far, and God loves us still. We are reminded of this in Romans chapter 8, verses 38 and 39. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, nor angels nor demons, neither the present nor the future, nor any powers, neither height nor depth, nor anything else in all of creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord. In the crush of it all, we can feel alone, forgotten, unwanted. And yet God has offered something more. God first left the very presence of God's self in the midst of the people with the Ark of the Covenant. Then God sent the Son, Jesus Christ, to be with us and to teach us. And so Jesus prepares to leave the disciples. Jesus reminds them that even when he goes, they will not be alone. The Holy Spirit will come and dwell within each of them. God does not leave us alone. John, in the 14th chapter, reminds us of what it means to not be alone. Don't be troubled. Trust in God. Trust also in me. My Father's house has room to spare. If that weren't the case, would I have told you that I'm going to prepare a place for you? When I go to prepare a place for you, I will return and take you to be with me, so that where I am, you will be too. You will know the way to the place I am going. I will ask the Father, and he will send another companion who will be with you forever. This companion is the Spirit of truth, whom the world can't receive because it neither sees him nor recognizes him. You know him because he lives with you and will be with you. I won't leave you as orphans. I will come to you. Soon the world will no longer see me, but you will see me. Because I live, you will live too. On that day, you will know that I am in the Father, you are in me, and I am in you. I have spoken these things to you while I am with you. The companion, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you everything and will remind you of everything I told you. Peace I leave you. My peace I give you. I give to you not as the world gives. Don't be troubled or afraid. I would invite you at this time to light a candle of your own. For those you have lost, and for the reminder that Christ shines in the darkness of pain, of suffering, of loneliness. We also light this, the Christ candle, remembering that Jesus Christ is always in the center of our lives. He hears our cries, he knows our hearts, and in the midst of all our thoughts and emotions, he offers us hope and healing.
I've had questions without answers. I've known sorrow, I have known pain. But there's one thing that I'll cling to. You are faithful, Jesus, you're true. When hope is lost, I call you Savior. When pain surrounds, I call you Healer. When silence falls, you'll be the song within my heart. In the lone hour of my sorrow, through the darkest night of my soul, you surround me and sustain me, my defender forevermore. When hope is lost, I call you Savior. When pain surrounds, I call you Healer. When silence falls, you'll be the song within my heart. I will tears fall, still I will sing to you. I will praise you, Jesus, praise you. Through the suffering, still I will sing. When hope is lost, I call you Savior. When pain surrounds, I call you Healer. When silence falls, you'll be the song.
Please use this musical postlude as a time of reflection and a reminder of the hope of Jesus Christ in a broken and hurting world, especially when it is your own. Amen.
Stood on as iron, one. Let me hold you. Dying without cause.
for stones to melt, for peace to see.